Hello everyone, welcome to the party. This is going to be so awesome. So, my name is Adolph Gaming. I am going to be doing a series on Kingdom Hearts 1.5, then 2.5, then 2.8. This is one of my all-time favorite series. It's amazing and I love it so much. And I'm so glad it got a remaster for this generation. So, for starters, this is not a 100% play walkthrough. I do not know where every single chest is. I'm not going to grind out every single enemy, trying to get that very last piece in order to make the ultimate keyblade, especially since you can't, like, transfer it to the next gameplay. If you could, I totally would. Hey, bud. So, for second off on the list, I'm going to be streaming this series, and a little bit of this will end up on YouTube as a recording. Let's see what else. I think that's about it. I'm going to try to make each YouTube video a recording of each individual world. That way I can just, like, label everything nicely. Aside from that, I think we should be good to go. So, without further ado, let's get into the first in the series. And for anybody wondering, since there's six games, the three that I wanted to do was 1.5, 2.5, and 2.8. If I get a lot of appreciation or looks or interest in the other games, I'll do that too. Maybe I'll probably end up doing them off camera for myself just so I can learn storyline. But if people want to see it, they need to give me like a heads up or say, hey, this is what we want. So, let's get right into it. Oh, this is going to be so cool. I wish I had the guidebook from the original game. But I played this enough times that I think I should be pretty good. Sure as hell not gonna do proud because I don't want to do high difficulty. I remember there are trophies involved, begin with rare items in easy mode. I kinda wanna take it easy. Here, give me one quick sec, I gotta check something real quick. Pre-ordering, and I wasn't sure if I got any bonus stuff for pre-ordering. So, on one hand, I want to play Final Mix just so it's a balanced regular difficulty, but on the other hand, I want the rare items because I have no idea what they are. So, we're going to start there. If it ends up looking sucky, I'll just redo it and we'll start on a higher difficulty. We'll do auto for right now. We do want vibration on, and we should be good to go. I don't know that a lot of people will be watching this, so I don't think anybody really cares about what difficulty I have it set at. But if somebody gives me static support, I might switch it up. So anyway, this is like the opening intro, very reminiscent. I love this shit. Oh, this is gonna be so good. Those graphics, man, it takes me back. This shit was even good on PlayStation.
I've been having
too.
These weird thoughts lately.
I'll shut up now.
Like, is any of this for real? Or not?
Thank you. so this part of the game is an opening tutorial on just basic movement, combat, how to use items, how to use equipment. And it's also going to be the setup for not only the difficulty, but some interesting things that you don't see in a lot of games, but it's like your decision. But decisions are all about getting and losing. So in this case, the setup that I want to go with is the power of the Guardian. And then next, it's going to ask me to throw something away. Now, in this playthrough, we're going to be doing the Path of the Sword for our throwaway. Now, the reason is, if you don't know any better, there's no real big difference in-game. But for little stuff in-game, you're going to notice that my defense is going to be a little bit higher, my attack is going to be a little bit weaker, and it's going to affect what prioritizes during the leveling of the campaign, because I believe there's 99 or 100 levels you can get, I think. It's been forever, so if I get my info wrong, please forgive me. So basically, this is going to be the starting stats and what takes priority when we level up. And the reason I chose these is because it's a great defense, a decent offense. I believe there's also, if I looked it up right, 2 MP, which is across the board unless you take staff, which the reason I didn't choose staff is because in this particular setup, we get 2 item slots for it. So it's totally worth our time. Now, we won't be keeping these items. These are just tutorial items. They're really straightforward. The green gauge on the right displays our health. If it runs out, we die. Blue is our MP for special abilities. Each of these things level up as we level up, increase as we level up. These are the Heartless. These are who we basically attack. We do straightforward combos. There's no special key combos whatsoever. The green orbs are health. We will take up items automatically whenever we walk next to them, including orbs, we'll pick up automatically. They gotta hit. Luckily, there's no penalty for getting hit other than you lose HP. There's a special thing about the lock-on. You can turn lock-on on and off where I have to click it manually on and off every single time. Or we have the choice to, it's only locked on so long as we hold the lock-on. Which I personally prefer because it's kind of a pain in the ass in case you want to change targets really quickly. And it's not fun. You're going to see a huge amount of Disney theme throughout the entire series. If you don't know that already, I'm kind of surprised. Let's check the... That's pause. That's aim. That's weird. That's up and down to select our commands. That's lock on. And we switched options. Holy crap. Can't be the share button. This is a puzzle game, somewhat. It's more combat heavy than it is puzzling, but it is puzzling. We're gonna have treasure chests all over the place. And in this case, the puzzle is open the door. So the first thing we do is we open the chest to learn how to open the chest. The second thing we do is beat the shit out of the barrel to pick up an item, no less. This will be a potion. That was an item box. Item boxes will be specific for what they do. Is how we switch targets. Maybe I can deal with the lock-on. So for puzzling, we're going to have a lot of doors and stuff. Not specifically like this, but unique challenges that in order to open something, we're going to have to do something different. God, I wish I had the guidebook. I want everything. I'm a completionist, so I gotta have everything. But I'm trying not to be a completionist for this playthrough. Later on, there's a few puzzles that'll be a pain in the ass, but we can get through it just fine. Okay, the next thing is we need to tell these kids about ourselves. Oh, and I forget how to do this just right, so we're gonna hope for the best here. God, I can't even remember what they do. Shit, it's about... The only one I really care about is leveling. Shit, being number one. We'll go with being number one. All of them have the same mannerisms whenever you talk to them. The reason I chose the answers I did specifically was because there's a leveling advantage in the game. So, this is all confusing because Sora's having a dream right now. That should be kind of obvious from the intro cutscene, so I shouldn't be ruining anything by saying that. What we just did is we decided the rate at which we're going to level up in this game. So, the ending communication that it said was... Press the option button over the options menu. And of course... This is how you open it, but you can't do that while you have combat, and then it spawns something, so you can't even practice. Damn, there's a lot of them. There really isn't a block button, so you kind of just gotta go with it. There's a skill, I believe, later on that gives you the ability to block, but it's not that useful. With these basic Heartless, these are, I can't remember the technical name, but they're not just basic Heartless. We just experienced our first level up because these guys are super easy. There's so much to talk about, and I keep getting distracted by the actual gameplay. It's so bad. Welcome back, Red. So, let's see. Only 15 minutes in, we're doing good. Okay. So, here we have our save point. I believe we also heal whenever we step into one of these. We will be wanting to save awesome often. What else? And then that's going to start the staircase up to the next level. You'll notice that all the platforms we're on are based off of Disney princess designs, and there's a reason for that, and we'll go more into it later. Now, we have save, party, which we don't have any party members yet other than ourselves, and menu... Okay, so apparently we can only access this stuff at a save point? Wow, that's penalizing as fuck. Oh, these are the bonus items. Power-ups, AP-ups, defense-ups. Oh, hell yeah. We got the equipment. We've got a... Reduce all elemental damage by 20% and an EXP boost. Oh my god, I'm so glad we did the first opening, like the easy difficulty, because that's going to make life so much easier. These are our stats. We're going to be able to see what we have equipped, items we have equipped. I have no idea what game this is, except there's a book of it. Okay, so Red, this is Kingdom Hearts 1.5. It's an old favorite of mine back from like a long time ago. I'll explain tons about it as time goes on, but it's basically an RPG with a lot of Disney elements in it, and you'll get to see a lot of cool combat. I'm not too worried about the configuration or the save menu, so we're going to go to save, and we're going to get our first save done. We shouldn't have to worry about being locked out of backtracking, because you can backtrack as much as you want. To go more into depth about the leveling that choices we made earlier, because it's stated that the journey will begin at dawn, that means that during level 1 through 50 we'll have bonus experience, but from 50 on we get bonus penalty where we won't get practically any experience. It's going to make end game really hard, but it's going to make the beginning game super strong and easy. Now, Kingdom Hearts is pretty straightforward in its combat, its story, everything. It's going to explain everything really well, but much. But the way it works, I can't watch full screen, like half. Oh, that sucks. Is it on your settings or is it mine? There's a lot of lore to this game. It's very, very deep. It's got a lot of fan forum, like, lore and thought process and everything. So, let's worry about the boss fight really quick. Jump. He's gonna do that. Okay, so most of the bosses have specific hit point areas that you have to hit. In this case, we're gonna start with his hands. If we can manage to stay up in the air, we don't have to worry about the minions doing actually really any damage to us. But when he's up high like that, you can't really do anything. With certain abilities, you have other options also. That's for the bad attacker, remember that. It's gonna curve around and hit me from behind. I'm just gonna take the hit. I'm not too worried about it. There's gonna be several blasts, but we're not gonna worry too much about it because I wanna get him dead as quickly as I possibly can. So anyway, this is Sora's shadow. This is what this boss is technically labeled as, I think. We're gonna see him a few times throughout the game. He's really not that bad for a boss. For a starting boss, it's actually pretty easy. With the hit to grab, because that's gonna do too much damage for me. Once we kill him, I'm guessing it'll be enough experience to get another level, to be honest. Come on, his ass. There we go, and there's our life level up. That it boosted our defense and it gave us an extra item slot. The only really complicated mechanic of being able to manage while in combat is I kept spamming the attack button because it was the selected icon on the bottom left part of the screen. It's really easy to forget what you have selected, whether it's items, attacks, specialties, but it's a pain in the ass. But anyway, we'll get more into that stuff here in a second. Let's just watch the cutscene.
Give me a break, Kairi.
Sora, you lazy bum. I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream. Or was it? I don't know. What was that place? So bizarre.
Yes, sure.
Say, Kairi, what was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
Do you ever want to go back?
Well, I'm happy here.
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other worlds out there. I want to see them all.
So what are we waiting for?
Hey! Aren't you guys forgetting about me? So, I guess I'm the only one working on the raft. And you're just as lazy as he is.
So you know this. Okay, we'll finish it together. I'll race you.
Huh? What? Are you kidding?
Ready?
So this is Destiny Island. broken up into multiple worlds. We're still in the tutorial premise of the game. Kyrie is going to tell us that we need to get some surprise. Yeah. Okay, I'm not going to really worry about 2 logs, cloth, rope, bring everything back here. If you need any help, just ask. Kind of. Okay, so there's items hidden throughout the island, and we have to pick everything up in order to get into the next part of the game. I don't remember specifically where 100% of everything is, but I think I can guess pretty quick because it hasn't been too long. You can't watch full screen right now. Okay, I get it. I thought it was something on my end, like a technical issue. So, here's the rope. If we want to, we can talk to each one of the kids on the island, and they'll have a different combat challenge, one with a sword, one with a ball, one with a jump rope or something. I'm not really worried about it. It's just to teach you the finer mechanics of the game. There's a back door, but we can't access it right now in the tutorial. There's another log in this area, but I can't remember where it's at. The camera is shaky as fuck. How do I change that? I have got to change the camera. It keeps, like, moving automatically, and I want to move it myself. We're gonna go inside the shack really quick because I know there's a save point in here. So let's see. Title screen, menu, configurations, auto lock on, off. Not my clue. I have that off target lock. I'm gonna use manual for right now. We're gonna do a manual camera, vibration on, no, that, can you change that? Oh, you can probably set it down, but you can't set it up, or maybe just permanently you can't do anything. We're gonna resave now that we've set up those, that stuff. Also, depending on, in the beginning, which of the combination of, like, sword, shield, or staff that I chose, it'll also dictate what skills are learned in what order. If I wanted to, I'm pretty sure I could challenge Riku over there to a fight. He's worth a little bit of EXP, but it's not really that worth it to me. But that's just me. I would rather save some time and just skip it. It's a little chunk of experience, but if you lose, and I don't think I could necessarily win because I'm out of practice, he keeps a tally of a win-loss ratio, and I don't want to have to deal with, like, his punk ass having a one-up on me.
So,
we already have to raise him in a minute.
Kyrie's home is out there somewhere, right?
Could be. We'll never know by staying here.
But how far could a rat take us?
Who knows?
I get you.
If we have to, we'll think of something else.
So, suppose you get to another world. What would you do there?
Well, I haven't really thought about it. It's just, I've always wondered why we're here, on this island. If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one? And suppose there are other worlds. Then ours is just a little piece of something much greater. So, we could have just as easily ended up somewhere else, right?
I don't know.
Exactly. That's why we need to go out there and find out. Just sitting here won't change a thing. It's the same old stuff. So let's go.
You've been thinking a lot lately, haven't you?
Thanks to you. If you hadn't come here, I probably would have never thought of any of this. Kyrie, thanks.
You're welcome.
Sora! You wanted one, didn't you?
A Paopu fruit?
If two people share one, their destinies become intertwined. They'll remain a part of each other's lives, no matter what. Come on, I know you want to try it.
What are you talking?
Ha ha ha.
much does the serious one. What?
Hey there, Donald. Good morning.
We've got a problem, Dookie. But don't tell anyone.
Ooh. Queen Minnie?
Not even the queen.
Daisy?
No! It's top secret.
Oh, good morning, ladies.
What?
Okay, so this is day two. We can fight all three of these kids all at once if we want to, which is a total pain in the ass. Let's see. I can't remember if there's any other items we need. I know I need to talk to Kyrie in order to get an item in this area, so we're actually going to backtrack you just a little bit. We'll probably go talk to Kyrie first, because basically what it is we need supplies, because the kids are planning to leave the island on a raft, and that's what we built yesterday. But as far as today goes, we need a bunch of items. Now, if we talk to Riku, we're going to start the next part of the challenge. I really don't want to do that. I need to test something really quick. Shit! I have to do a foot race against him in a minute. That's going to break. I broke too quick. Okay. Chest up there that we can't get to. We'll be coming back in a long time from now, and we'll grab that. This should be one of the items. Some mushrooms. I gotta talk to her and remember what the items are. Hey, let me see Riku. She's gonna tell me we have to go race with Riku before we can actually do the item part of it. If I manage to get all the items, then we get a bonus, like, oh god, what is it? It's like a, it's like a high potion or something. So, one of the items is two or three coconuts, and I'm waiting because the brown ones don't work for this. They have to be green. I don't know if it's totally random or if you have to get the right ones. Do I have to talk to her? God, it's been so long. Maybe we should just do the race. Okay, so basically, the raft needs a name, and Riku likes his name, and Sora, who we're playing as Sora, wants to name it something else. So we do a foot race to determine the name of the ship. Now, at first, there's one. Oh, no. Grab it before it disappears. So, basically, the name of the ship is relevant because we're going to have a ship later on in the game that's going to have this title. And as far as competition goes, I would rather be able to name the ship than let Riku get to name our ship. There's another one. I think it's two, but just in case, we're going to grab a third. Hopefully we can run the race in one try, because that's what's required. The whole premise of the race is being able to jump and run faster than Riku. If we fall down off of the wood, we're going to end up in the water and we're going to lose time. The second thing is to climb up this and then jump on or not. I can't remember what's the fastest path, but I swear to God, the fastest path is this. Okay, so we're going to jump onto that. And it's gonna zip line us. Now, if we don't make it up here, we have to take the alternate route and jump on these trees. Oh, shit. This is gonna be a very bad race. This is gonna be a very bad race. But I'm really sure the fastest route is that. I really think. I can't remember for sure, but I'm pretty sure. Alright, let's talk to him. I would rather go with that, so we're gonna see. Okay, so she's gonna judge the race. Fail number two is for sure. You can see the treasure chest hiding out in the alcove, but again, we won't be able to get it in time. The key is to get to that platform with that star tree.
If I win, to be the winner. I'm captain. And if you win,
I get to share the Palpu with Kairi.
Huh?
Deal? The winner gets to share a Palpu with Kairi.
Wait a minute.
Okay, on my count.
So now we definitely gonna win. I cut him off. He'll take it if we don't. So, we managed to beat him. No! Oh, fuck, I lost. No, I jumped off of it! I wasn't supposed to jump off of it! Shit! Oh well. Fail number three. So, we have to make it there and back. There's no way we can beat him. He's literally got too much of an advantage. God, that sucks so bad, dude. And he's just taunting us now. I'm really sure I can't beat him. Definitely can't beat him now. Oh, God, that's disgusting! Oh! Damn it. Look at that pouty face. Okay. Well, that sucked. Again, it's been a long time, and it's really iffy. The fact that we knocked him off the ledge for that was super cool. There's another mushroom we needed. But I didn't know if I jumped again, I would fly off of the thing, so that just sucks. So let's check with Kairi to see what we need for the provisions for the trip. Seagull egg, we've got two mushrooms, we got the coconuts we need, and three fish, and fill up this drinking water, but not from the ocean. Okay, I know where everything is. We've got enough of the coconuts. We have two of the three mushrooms, but we're going to get the mushroom last, and you'll see why in a minute. We're going to go for the seagull egg, the fresh water, and the three fish. I don't know why we're getting all this crap. It's kind of silly, but whatever. So, as far as the fish go, all of them are out in the ocean here, and we have to swim after them, and this is just actually, that was not that bad. The fresh water she's talking about, it can't be from the ocean. She's specifically saying she wants it from this spring, and she gave us the bottle for it, so we got that done. Then we're going to go with the seagull's egg, which is right up here. And again, this is more tutorial stuff, just to teach you how to move and everything like that. Got the seagull egg. The last thing should be the mushroom now. If you've never played the game, it can be a total pain in the ass to find, but there's basically this secret little path in back here, and mushrooms are always in the darkness. You can go back to the last save and try again. I really would go back to the last save and try again if I wanted to cheat it, but he won fair and square, so I'm just gonna let it go. Now, this room is really important because that doorway is something significant, and we get to have a really weird cutscene that doesn't make any sense if you don't know any of the lore, and I'll try to explain it just a little bit in a minute.
To see the door to this world.
Huh?
This world has been connected.
Well, what are you talking about?
Tied to the darkness. Soon to be completely eclipsed.
Well, whoever you are, stop freaking me out like this. Huh? Well, where did you come from?
You do not yet know what lies beyond the door.
So you're from another world.
There is so very much to learn. You understand so little.
Oh yeah? Well, you'll see. I'm gonna get out and learn what's out there.
A meaningless effort. One who knows nothing can understand nothing.
That dude's gone. This is a cave where they used to, like, draw and stuff in, I guess. That doorway is, like, super important, and I'm gonna explain it more, like, later on. Because we're not gonna be worrying about that doorway very long, and the whole thing is a little bit more unique. So now we should have all the provisions. We're gonna head back to Kyrie. We're gonna drop off the stuff. Should wrap up the majority of the tutorial, and then we have one last cutscene or so before we actually get into the meat of the game. That is super important too. So for bringing her all the items, we got a high potion. Those are useful later.
You know, Riku has changed.
What do you mean?
Well...
You okay?
Sora, let's take the raft and go. Just the two of us.
Huh?
Just kidding.
What's gotten into you?
What a tease.
You're the one that's changed, Kairi.
Maybe. You know, I was a little afraid at first, but now I'm ready. No matter where I go or what I see, I know I can always come back here. Right?
Yeah, of course.
That's good. Sora, don't ever change.
Huh?
I just can't wait. Once we set sail, it'll be great. Thank you.
this mean?
It means we'll just have to trust the king.
Gosh, I sure hope he's all right.
Your Highness, don't worry. We'll find the king and the key.
Thank you, both of you.
This is can you take care of them?
Of course. You be careful now, both of you.
Oh, and to chronicle your travels, he will accompany you.
Over here! Cricket's the name. Jiminy Cricket, at your service.
We hope for your safe return. Please, help the king.
You're coming too!
Gosh, Jiminy, your world disappeared too?
It was terrible. We were scattered. And as far as I can see, I'm the only one who made it to this castle.
You see?
Oh, right. I gotcha. You mean while we're in other worlds, we can't let on where we're from, huh? We gotta protect the world border.
Order!
Right. World border. I guess we'll need new duds when we get there, huh?
This is where the gravity's gonna crap is on the spaceships.
Can't wait. Once we set sail, it'll be great.
A storm?
Oh no! The raft!
Sora! Dinner's ready! Come on down! Sora?
Boat and Kairi's.
Now, in the opening tutorial, we had a nice keyblade. I almost spoiled it. I did spoil it. We had a shield to use as a weapon to defend ourselves. This wooden sword will not kill these guys or even damage them, I don't think. So, one, we're running over to Riku.
Where's
two,
Kairi?
You see the door in the background.
She was with
that's
you.
Important.
The door. Is open.
What?
The door is open, Sora. Now we can go to the outside world.
What are you talking about? We gotta find Kairi.
Kairi's coming with us. Once we step through, we might not be able to come back. We may never see our parents again. There's no turning back. but this may be our only chance. We can't let fear stop us. I'm not afraid of the darkness.
This is kind of like the dream.
Riku. That was in
the
old. Everything, but Sora.
For right now, just cinematics are all we have to go on. Open. It worked. And we get thrown away. This guy, in case you missed it earlier, is, in the dream, this guy was created from our shadow. That's where he came from. But that was only in the dream, and now we just fought him in real life, kind of thing. That was fun. I honestly am surprised. I kind of expected a level out of that.
Oh, look! A star's going out!
Come on, let's travel! The world we were just on just went out. So that kind of sucks. And this is Traverse Town. Which I'm gonna pause. pause this real quick to stop the recording.